Hello everyone, I welcome all the English viewers, people from South India and Northeast India to this video. In this video, I will bring to you the best multiple choice questions from the second week of December. I will cover 150 questions, and let me tell you, the questions are extremely superb this week round, because a lot had happened in the international arena. And also, if you are preparing for UPSC, for India Post Payment Bank, IBPS clerk mains, or for central warehousing, then this video will be extremely beneficial for you. In fact, it is even more important than the first week, because the quality of questions is very good. If you want to follow me on Facebook, you can find the link in the description below. And we have updated our SSC CGL and Railways pen drive. Now, one more thing, that if you want to avail the pen drive, you will also get every week minimum 2 updated videos on our website. So that is a bonus for you. And the pen drive is updated. Also, I have posted just yesterday one video of sentence correction on the website. Do download it if you are a pen drive buyer. And for Kendriya Vidyalaya and CLAT, it's quite hot selling right now. And for hotel management also, you can avail it. If you want to buy any pen drive, just dial this number 9580048004, or shoot me an email, gaurav.studyiq@gmail.com. So without further delay, let me begin the questions. So the first question is, Kerala Chief Minister Mr. Pinarayi Vijayan, he launched which scheme in Thiruvananthapuram to clean the water bodies in the state, and to basically do the waste management also, and to increase the cultivable area, that is, increase the agricultural area in the state. That is only possible when there is a proper cleaning. And let me tell you about Pinarayi Vijayan. He is from Communist Party of India, Marxist. That is, he is from left party. So he is the CM of Kerala. And the name of the scheme for this particular thing, that is to clean the water bodies and for waste management, is Harita Keralam. Harita Keralam. This scheme was launched by him on the December the 8th, 2016. Which state recently became the 18th state to join Ujjwal Discom Assurance Yojana? Now, please note that Ujjwal Discom Assurance Yojana, in short, is called UDAY. What is the meaning of Discom? The power distribution companies are called Discom, in short. Power distribution company, in short, Discom. And all our power distribution companies are in heavy debt, heavy losses. So the government needs to infuse a new lease of life into the companies, and therefore this scheme has been started. Now, one more thing, that since it is a scheme by the central government, and central government is of BJP, therefore the earlier states to adopt this are all BJP states, whereas the states which have woken up so late are all Congress states. So that is also one of the clue. Now 18th state is definitely a laggard and not a early adopter, so therefore this is Himachal Pradesh, because Himachal Pradesh has Congress government, and Himachal Pradesh capital is Shimla, and CM is Veerbhadra Singh from Congress party. Madhya Pradesh, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, all the three states have BJP government. Now please also note that the first state to adopt UDAY scheme was Jharkhand. That's right. And there is a very similar scheme, not in terms of content, but in terms of optics, which is UDAN. So don't get confused between UDAY and UDAN. UDAN was, the first state to adopt UDAN was Assam. And UDAN is basically to make sure that, the air tickets are affordable to each and every person. So that is UDAN scheme, also called UDAY Desh Ka Aam Nagrik. Now, in which train, which is also the world's first hospital train, India, it is in India, there were 2 new coaches that were added. Now, this is an easy question. This is the world's first hospital train, and previously there were 5 coaches in this train. And now 2 more coaches are added, so the number has become 7. This is the Lifeline Express. It is the world's first hospital train, and it has made difference to the lives of a lot of people, especially in the rural areas. Now, there are 2 banks. One is the Bank of Abu Dhabi, okay, and one is the First Gulf Bank. Now, Abu Dhabi is the capital of UAE, United Arab Emirates, and there is a bank called First Gulf Bank. Together, they have merged into each other to create a very big company, to create a behemoth. Behemoth means very big enterprise. Now, this enterprise, which is created by the merger of these two, is it is the biggest bank of all the Gulf countries put together. And its assets are in the range of $178 billion. So what is the name of this big bank that is formed by merging of these 2 big banks? So that will be called NBAD, National Bank of Abu Dhabi, NBAD. This is very, very important question. NBAD will be the bank which will be formed by the merger of Bank of Abu Dhabi and First Gulf Bank. Now, Pakistan, it has cancelled or removed or revoked the ban on import of which product from India? Through Wagha and Karachi port. Wagha is a border in near Amritsar, and Karachi is a coastal city with very beautiful beaches like Clifton Beach, etc. Now, Pakistan, you know, the relations between the two countries are not the best right now, and therefore Pakistan had, you know, put the ban on which product. Now that ban has been removed because the relations, they are starting to kind of get streamlined, not exactly improving, but kind of, you know, not worse than during the surgical strike. So the product was cotton. Cotton is grown in black soil, and that black soil is also called regur. R-E-G-U-R, regur. Now, please also note that black soil, we get it in volcanic plateaus, like the Kathiawad plateau in Gujarat, like the Deccan, you know, like the, you know, the central, the Malwa plateau. These were all the plateaus of volcanic origin, and therefore the soil was black in nature. So cotton is best grown in black soil. Which company has been named as the company of the year by Fortune magazine in its annual blue ribbon ranking? Company of the year by Fortune magazine. This is the parent company of Google. Okay, so it is Alphabet. Alphabet is the parent company of Google. Now, which company got this award? It is called CII National Quality 2016 Award. And why did they get this award? For practicing various EFQM models. That is for good implementation of EFQM model. Now, what is EFQM? It is European Foundation for Quality Management. And all of these four companies, they are PSUs. But the company that got this award is BEML. Now, please note that there is a difference between BEML and BHEL. BHEL is Bharat Heavy Electrical Limited, whereas BEML is Bharat Earth Movers Limited. Okay, and this GAIL, SAIL and BHEL, they are Maharatan companies. With which country India has signed a memorandum of understanding for cooperation in the space technology? And you know that space technology can be used for a lot of things, like for agriculture, for weather forecasting, for telling when tsunami will come, you know, for mapping, GPRS, etc. So India will cooperate, the two countries will cooperate with each other in the space technology, in education, agriculture, weather forecasting and all these. So with which country we have signed this MOU? We have signed it with Afghanistan. And you know that the head of state of Afghanistan, Mr. Ashraf Ghani, was on a visit to India recently because of the Heart of Asia conference, which was in Amritsar. And Afghanistan capital is Kabul. It's an important ally of India. Now, there is a scheme started by the central government, which is called ZED certification scheme. And this is basically to increase the quality in the MSME sector. That is the micro, small and medium enterprise sector. Now, please expand ZED. What is the full form of ZED? The full form is Zero Effect, Zero Defect. Zero Effect, Zero Defect. This is a scheme which will be for quality control in the MSME sector. Now, Tata Institute of Fundamental Research. Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, the scientists at this institute, they have discovered something that there is a semi-metal, okay? And when we put that semi-metal in this temperature, minus 273 degrees Celsius, this temperature is 530 microkelvin. Please note that the SI unit, Standard Internationale, or the standard unit for temperature is not Celsius, it is Kelvin. Okay, that is one mistake which people do in physics. Okay, now when we put this metal into 530 microkelvin, then it starts acting as a superconductor. So which metal is this? And this is a discovery, indigenous discovery, that is by our own institute, that is Tata Institute. So this metal is bismuth. Now recently, there was a training program which was organized by the Election Commission of India. And this was basically, you know, how to conduct free and fair elections, how to carry out, you know, proper election management in the democratic countries. Now, this was conducted for which organization's countries? This particular workshop or so to say training program by the Election Commission of India, this was conducted for the SAARC countries. India is a member of SAARC and there are 8 countries in SAARC. South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. India is also a member of SCO, which is Shanghai Cooperation Organization. In fact, last year, in 2015 only, India and Pakistan both have become the members of SCO, China dominated. Then G20, yes, India is a member of G20. And MGC, yes, India is a member of Mekong Ganga Cooperation also. Now, how much discount will be given to people who buy monthly seasonal tickets in the suburban railway networks through digital payment mode? Now, the Ministry of Finance, it has been trying its best, to encourage people to do cashless transactions. And it is giving out a lot of vouchers, a lot of schemes. So this is part of one of the schemes. There are three important announcements made. I have converted all the three announcements into MCQs. So the first announcement is this. If you buy your railway seasonal tickets, okay, in the suburban areas, then what will be the discount that you will get, provided you pay through cashless medium, that is digital transaction has to be made. So you will get a discount of 0.5%. Second announcement was, if you buy your railway ticket through online mode, again cashless, you will be enabled to get free accident insurance cover of how much amount? The amount is 10 lakh rupees. 10 lakh rupees is the amount. And the third announcement was this. If you buy an insurance policy online, again, you pay for it cashless, okay? Any insurance policy of public sector undertaking, like LIC, NIACL, UICL, and all that. Then, how much discount you will get on general insurance as well as on life insurance respectively, which means that the first data, the first figure in percentage is of general insurance, second is of life insurance. So you will get 10% off on general insurance and 8% on life insurance. So the answer is D. Uttarakhand High Court. Uttarakhand has, the Congress government. The Chief Minister is Mr. Harish Rawat. It is also called Dev Bhumi. Now, Uttarakhand High Court directed the state government to impose complete ban on liquor in three districts. So, the Uttarakhand government is liable to ban liquor in three districts. Which of these is not one of those? So, let me tell you which are those three districts. Uttarkashi is there. Rudraprayag is there. Chamoli is there. So, yeah, Pauri Garhwal is not there. So, the answer is A. Uttarkashi district is quite popular because the river Ganga originates, the holy Ganges originates from Uttarkashi as well as Yamuna also. Now, Ganges takes its origin from the Gangotri Glacier. Yamuna takes its origin from Yamunotri Glacier. Both rivers are parallel to each other. So, the answer is here A. Pauri Garhwal is not one of these. The Food Safety and Standards Authority of India, the job of this organization is to make sure that the food is as per the acceptable standards as laid down in their framework. So FSSAI banned the use of which object for wrapping or packing of food items? So as per FSSAI, now you cannot wrap your food or pack your food in this silver foil, newspaper, aluminium foil or leaves of trees. Now in all of these, we usually wrap food, but now they have said that they have banned newspapers. As per them, there are some chemicals or dirty elements in newspaper which can get transmitted to the food, and therefore it is potentially hazardous to our health. So newspapers is the answer. Larsen & Toubro, L&T. It is into many disciplines like IT, like construction, project management. So L&T was awarded a contract by Gujarat Cricket Administration, Gujarat Cricket Association, and this is basically to make which stadium world's biggest cricket stadium in terms of seating capacity. So L&T will have to make this particular stadium the world's biggest cricket stadium in terms of sitting, in terms of the number of audience that can sit. It is the Sardar Patel Cricket Stadium in Ahmedabad. HPCA Stadium in Dharamshala is the highest stadium in India, that is located at an altitude which is highest. Green Park Stadium is in Kanpur. Firoz Shah Kotla, Delhi, the famous ground where Anil Kumble took 10 wickets against Pakistan. Now, what is the name of the TV channel that is launched by our Union Minister of Electronics and Information Technology, Shri Ravi Shankar Prasad? And this TV channel is basically launched. It has been started to promote digital transactions, cashless transactions. It will spread awareness about the same in the rural areas. So what is the name that has been given to this TV channel? The name is Digi Shala. And who is our Union Minister for Information Technology? It is Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad. Who defeated Indian Saurav Kothari to win the 2016 IBSF World Billiards Long-Up title at Bengaluru? Now please note that there are two questions in this. One, who won the IBSF World Billiards Championship? The answer to that was Pankaj Advani. But if they ask you IBSF World Billiards long up title, look out for this word, long up. Then the answer is Peter Gilchrist. Peter Gilchrist is not from Australia as the surname Gilchrist suggests. He is from Singapore. Okay, so Peter Gilchrist beat Indian Saurav Kothari to win World Billiards long up title at Bengaluru. Now, scientists from University of Illinois. Illinois is one of the biggest states in US. Even Chicago is in Illinois. Chicago is just like our Mumbai, you know, big towers like that. So scientists from the University of Illinois have discovered the presence of which atoms in the thermosphere. So thermosphere is our second highest layer of the atmosphere. And which atoms have been discovered by the scientists from the University of Illinois in thermosphere? It is the hydrogen atom. That's right. Hydrogen, we write it as H2 because this is one molecule. It is in diatomic state. The atom is written as H. Methane is CH4. It is a greenhouse gas, combustible gas. Lithium is Li. And helium is, of course, HE. And on sun, you have hydrogen fusing to form helium plus a lot of energy is liberated. Now, which Olympic gold medalist, okay, created a world record in the men's 100 meter butterfly final of the FINA short course world swimming championship held at Windsor, Ontario? Do you remember the last Olympic Games? No, not this year's 2016 Rio de Janeiro Olympics. I'm talking about the previous Olympics, that is 2012 London Olympics. Do you remember that Michael Phelps was the firm favorite for the 100 meter butterfly, but he was beaten by, I think, 100th of a second by this legendary swimmer from South Africa. Okay, he's from South Africa. He created the world record previously and now he has beaten his own world record. His name is Chad Lacloss. Chad Lacloss. Our Railway Minister, Mr. Suresh Prabhu, and Haryana's Chief Minister Manohar Lal Khattar of the Bharatiya Janata Party, they flagged off a special train. They have started a special train in Haryana, which is called the Geeta Jayanti train. And you know that Haryana is also celebrating Geeta festival in Kurukshetra, the very place where the Battle of Mahabharata took place. So Geeta Jayanti train has been started by the government of Haryana. Now the question is, it will run between which two stations? So one station you can very well make out, which will be Kurukshetra, where the Battle of Mahabharata was fought. Which is the other? The other is in Uttar Pradesh. It is Mathura. So this train, Geeta Jayanti train, will run between Kurukshetra and Mathura. In India, what percentage of persons with disability? So we don't really call them disabled people now. We rather prefer to call them differently abled. They are able and they have been able to achieve heights, even, you know, more esteemed heights, bigger and better heights than the people who are not disabled. So that is why they are called differently abled. They can achieve anything as proven in our history time and again. Now, there is a word which is given to these people by our Prime Minister Narendra Modi. They are called Divyang. They will not be called Viklang or disabled. They will be rather called Divyang. So remember this word. And what percentage of these people with disability are illiterate? And this is as per the Social Development Report of 2016. The number of these people, disabled people or differently abled people who are illiterate is 45%. And this is alarming because even in Kerala, which is a very, you know, which has very high literacy, they, you know, 33% people, persons with disability are illiterate. So that is quite alarming. Rajasthan High Court has cancelled the Rajasthan Special Backward Classes Reservation Act 2015 that allowed for how much percentage quota to Gujjars and five other communities of the state. And this is very, very important. See, Supreme Court has a guideline that is, in no circumstances should the reservation in a state be allowed to exceed 50%. In Rajasthan, it has crossed even 60% because they are giving reservation to Gujjars and five other communities. How much reservation was given? 5%. And it has been struck down now by the Rajasthan High Court. And if you remember previously also, the Jats from Bharatpur and Dholpur, they were demanding reservation and the government succumbed to their demands. But the case is going on. It is sub judice in Supreme Court. And I'm very sure it will be struck down too. So the answer is 5%. Rajasthan capital is Jaipur, Pink City, and it has a Bharatiya Janata Party government. Vasundhara Raje is the CM. Now, who became the first Canadian woman? Canada. The capital is Ottawa. Canada's head of state is Justin Trudeau. His father was also the head of state of Canada once upon a time. First Canadian woman to be featured on the Canada's $10 currency note. Now this dollar is the Canadian dollar, it is not American dollar. So Canadian dollar, $10 currency note, who became the first Canadian woman to be featured. Her name is Viola Desmond, and she has done a lot of work. She has done seminal work in uplifting the society. She is a civil rights activist. Coca-Cola, the famous beverage company, has appointed which person as their new CEO, chief executive officer? So previously it was Mr. Muhtar Kent, who was the CEO of Coca-Cola. Now it is James Quincy. So James Quincy has replaced Muhtar Kent as the CEO of a Fortune 100 company. Which German company has acquired Food Panda? Now you must also have ordered on Food Panda, you know. Food Panda has been acquired by a big German company. The headquarter of this company is in fact in the capital, Berlin. Okay. And Food Panda, as you know, it's an online food ordering and delivery website. So which company has acquired Food Panda? It is Delivery Hero. Now they have not disclosed the amount, but it must be in hundreds of millions. Which state of India is carrying out the biggest and the first ever crop insurance claim distribution program in Indian history? See, there are 20 lakh farmers in this state who are availing this facility, and they will be compensated for their crop damages. So this has been unprecedented. It has not happened in the Indian history before. And therefore, which state is carrying out this biggest and the first ever crop insurance claim distribution program? And this is being done by the chief minister of this state, Shivraj Singh Chauhan. So now you can easily guess the state. It is Madhya Pradesh. The capital is Bhopal. Which state has started a special train? The name of this special train is Wadi Ki Sair. Sair means, you know, when you go for a stroll, like a tour, and Wadi is a valley. So a tour of the valley, it's a special train started. It's basically for children, and this train will run between Banihal and Baramula. Baramula and Banihal. So Banihal pass, you know, Baramula railway station, you know. So the answer is easy now, Jammu and Kashmir. And this train was started by, flagged off by none other than a person no less than the chief minister of the state, Mehbooba Mufti of the PDP. In which country, world's longest rail tunnel, okay, it is called Gotthard Base Tunnel, or GBT in short. Please note that this tunnel has taken 17 years to get built, and not only that, it has been built at an estimate cost of $12 billion. So some great work must have gone through. So in which country this world's longest rail tunnel has become operational? Okay, it is, by the way, 57 kilometer long train, and this is Switzerland. The capital of Switzerland is Bern. There are some important towns in Switzerland, like you have Basel, from where Roger Federer is there. Then you have Zurich, then you have Geneva, where a lot of headquarters are there of important organizations. So Switzerland is an important place with respect to GK. Now, which state government has tied up with Tata Trust to basically streamline their public distribution system? And now the public distribution system will be Aadhaar linked. So it will be called Aadhaar Enabled Public Distribution System, in short AEPDS, Aadhaar Enabled. So which state government has tied up with Tata to acquire digital platform to strengthen their PDS? This has been done under the leadership of Akhilesh Yadav. So the answer is Uttar Pradesh. The capital is Lucknow, and Akhilesh Yadav is from Samajwadi Party, which is one of the rare socialist parties in India. What is the name of the biography of gymnast Deepa Karmakar? See, Deepa Karmakar, you know, she is the first Indian gymnast ever to qualify for the Olympics. She performed brilliantly. She even jumped, risked her life. Prodyunova is the name of the jump which she undertook. And it was a valiant effort by her. But things were not to be. And she finished fourth. She missed the medal by a whisker. But there is a biography which is written by three people. One is Vimal Mohan, one is Digvijay Singh Deo, and the third is the coach of Deepa Karmakar, Bishweshwar Nandi. So this is another question. Who is the coach of Deepa Karmakar? The answer is Bishweshwar Nandi. And the name of the book is Deepa Karmakar, The Small Wonder. Deepa Karmakar, The Small Wonder. The International Olympic Committee has granted provisional recognition to which sport or sports for 3 years. So next Olympics, you know, it will be in Tokyo in 2020, capital of Japan. An International Olympic Committee has granted provisional recognition, which means that after 3 years, they will review and they might add this sport in the Olympics. This status of provisionally recognized sport has been given to two sports. One is the martial art of Muay Thai and second is cheerleading. So the answer is C, both 1 and 2. And chess so far has not been added in Olympics. Which female became the first Pakistani woman to join the bomb disposal unit? That is the bomb diffusion squad. And this is an empowerment. This is women empowerment. What is the name of this female? The name is Rafia Kasim Baig. She has become the first Pakistani woman, first woman in Pakistani history to join the bomb disposal unit. Kiran Bedi is adopting which village under model village scheme? So Kiran Bedi, you know, she is the lieutenant governor of Puducherry. Okay, Puducherry. And the Puducherry's chief minister is V. Narayana Swami. Kiran Bedi is adopting which village under model village scheme? Now, lot of our parliamentarians are also adopting villages under the Pradhan Mantri model village scheme or the Sansad Adarsh Gram Yojana. Kiran Bedi is adopting this village. Just mug up the name. It is Thimmanaikan Palayam. And look at this village, Khutia. Khutia is a village which will be adopted by our HRD minister, Prakash Javadekar. This village is also important. Puttam Rajuvari Kandriga. It is a village which was adopted by legendary Sachin Tendulkar and there has been immense improvement in the village. In fact, it has become a model village. Golpalli is a village which will be adopted by Sachin Tendulkar. Please note the difference. Puttam Rajuvari Kandriga is the village which Sachin Tendulkar had adopted 2 years back. Golpalli is the village which he is adopting right now. Besides, there is one more village which you should know. It is called Jayapur. Jayapur in Varanasi constituency. Narendra Modi adopted it 2 years back, but there was a report recently which said that no improvement has been done in this, let alone model village. This village has not taken off. It is just like it was 2.5 years back. So these are some of the villages which you should know. Oil and Natural Gas Corporation, ONGC, which is a Maharatan company, again one of the most important PSUs of India, it is setting up a new basin in which city by 2017 to increase focus on exploration of oil and gas in the northeast region. And this is very important for the energy security of India, that we find new basins to explore oil and gas. And this particular basin by ONGC will be set up at the capital of Tripura, which is Agartala. So the answer is Agartala. Which book was recently launched by our President Pranab Mukherjee on his 81st birthday? So he recently celebrated his 81st birthday. Pranab Mukherjee, he lives at Raisina Hill. Raisina Hill is the place where Rashtrapati Bhavan is there. And he in fact launched not one, not two, but three books. So the answer is all of these. These are the three books which he launched. First is the Rashtrapati Bhavan, From Raj to Swaraj. Second book is Indra Dhanush, the second. And third is Life at Rashtrapati Bhavan. Where is Sambar Lake located? That was in news recently. Please note that Sambar Lake is the lake which has the highest salinity in India, but it is not the largest salty lake in India. If they ask which is the largest saltwater lake in India, it is the Chilka Lake or the Chilka Lake in Odisha. But the highest salinity means the quantity of salt per liter of water is maximum in Sambar Lake. It is in Jaipur in Rajasthan. So why was it in news? Because the National Green Tribunal, it directed the Rajasthan government to cancel the allotments of salt pans in Sambar Salt Lake to preserve the wetland ecosystem. Which protein has been identified by the scientist at the Institute for Research in Biomedicine, Barcelona? Barcelona is a place in the Catalonia region of Spain, and very famous football club is also there, Barcelona, that is responsible for spreading cancer. So according to the scientist at this university in Barcelona, which is the protein that causes cancer? It is the CD36. And cancer is of two types. One is benign cancer, which is relatively less dangerous, and the very, very dangerous malignant cancer, which spreads from one area to another. The process of spreading is called metastasis. Who was honored with the highest French civilian award, which is called Legion of Honor? Now, it's quite funny that every month France gives this award to one person. Now, I've been noticing it for the past 2 years. Every month in news, there is one person given this honor. So you have to mug up all the names, and also you have to look for the latest name. because in exam they will often ask the latest recipient of this award. It is the French Civilian Award, highest French Civilian Award. It is called in French Ordre National de la Légion d'honneur or Legion of Honor. It was bestowed upon John Kerry. Who is John Kerry? Under Obama administration, he is the Secretary of State. And once upon a time, John Kerry was also the presidential candidate against George Bush, if you remember. Now, John Kerry and Obama, they will be history on 20th of Jan, because 20th of Jan is the date when Obama will be exiting from the White House and Donald Trump will go in the White House. Now, Rex Tillerson is again very important person because he has been made the Secretary of State by Donald Trump. So from 21st of January, Mr. Rex Tillerson will be the Secretary of State of USA. Which company has launched its first full-scale cybersecurity engagement center, which is called CSEC in short? And it is there, in fact, it is their first cybersecurity center in India, and they have started it, launched it at New Delhi. So which company is this? In fact, the CEO, chief executive officer of this company is an Indian. His name is Satya Nadella from Hyderabad. The name of the company is Microsoft. DGAD. What is DGAD? DGAD is Directorate General of Anti-Dumping and Allied Duties. The job of DGAD is to see if any inferior quality products are being dumped into the India, you know, Indian markets. Also to check whether the proper import duties are being put so that our domestic markets are protected. Now, what happens in China is that China puts almost no export duty. Now, this is unofficial, of course, so that their products are remain very cheap. They don't put any export duty. So when they come to India, these products are very, very cheap. Chinese products are very, very cheap. And therefore, they compete with the Indian products, and Indian products are not able to compete in price. And therefore, Indian markets suffer. Indian manufacturing sector suffers badly. So DGAD has recommended imposing import duty, dumping duty. That is, import duty will be put up on these products so that their price is at par with the Indian product. So this they have recommended on steel tubes and steel pipes. Now there was a museum for vintage tapestry. What is tapestry? See, tapestry is kind of these mats and carpet. Very beautiful carpets which hang down from the wall usually. And also museum for carpet. Where was it inaugurated recently in India? It was inaugurated by, again, our President Pranab Mukherjee on his 81st birthday at Rashtrapati Bhavan, his residence. 7 Lok Kalyan Marg. Lok Kalyan Marg is the new name of Racecourse Road. It is the address of the Prime Minister of India. 7 Racecourse Road or 7 Lok Kalyan Marg where Modi stays. 10 Janpath is the address where Sonia Gandhi stays. European Union, EU, it has signed an agreement with the government of which country to enable the return of migrants, to grant them asylum. Now, what happened is this country's refugees, they have reached the shores of the European Union. So European Union will take care of these refugees. They will grant them temporary asylum. They will help them return back to the country. This country is Mali. Please don't confuse Mali with Bali. Bali is a place in Indonesia, whereas Mali is a small African country. Scientists from the Carl Schurz Institute of Technology, they have detected which gas in the upper troposphere layer for the first time above India and China. Now, India and China, their atmosphere, that is troposphere. See, atmosphere, there are many layers. First layer is called troposphere, second is called stratosphere, and so on. Stratosphere is the layer which has ozone layer, so to protect us from the harmful ultraviolet rays, especially ultraviolet C, and it also is the layer stratosphere in which the aeroplanes fly. Now, coming to troposphere, it is the layer where there are a lot of climatic disturbances. All the weather phenomena are restricted to troposphere. So, in the troposphere, which gas has been detected by the scientists from the Carl Schurz Institute of Technology? It is ammonia, NH3. N2 is nitrogen, CH4 is methane, O3 is ozone, and O2 is oxygen. Which country will provide tsunami early warning system to the South China Sea countries? Now, this is very important. This is strategic because we need to come closer to the South China Sea countries like Philippines, like Vietnam, like Indonesia, and so on. Because we need to, encircle China. So, it is in fact India which is providing this technology, that is tsunami early warning system, to South China Sea countries. When do we observe Universal Health Coverage Day? And it is observed by United Nations itself, that is, it is validated by the United Nations with an aim to promote the human right to health. So basically what is happening is that healthcare is going into private hands in most of the countries, which is not good because the out-of-pocket expense for patients increases and they are pushed into the poverty. That is what is exactly happening in India. So there has to be universal health coverage day, and I should say that this day is the most important with respect to the developing countries like India. So we celebrate it every year on December the 12th. Now, Joko Widodo visited India recently. He is president of which country? Joko Widodo. Joko Widodo is president of Indonesia. Indonesia, the capital is Jakarta. And there are a lot of MOUs also which are signed between Indonesia and Indonesia and India. Now, please note that Indonesia has a very old cultural, connection with India. In fact, Indonesia, one place is called Sumatra, which is a big island near Andaman, Nicobar. Look at the name Sumatra and connected with the Ramayana character. Also, the national airline of Indonesia is called Garuda Airlines. Okay, Garuda, which was again a character, mythological character. So Indonesia and India have, Indonesia has also a lot of temples. So answer is Indonesia. Now, Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi, he attended a program organized by the Banas Kantha Cooperative Milk Producers Union, which is the Banas Dairy at Disa. In which state do we have this dairy at Disa in the, the Banas Kantha Cooperative Milk Producers Union? And the 50 years of this dairy were celebrated. Also, he inaugurated a cheese plant and a whey drying plant at Palanpur. Now, please don't confuse Palanpur with Palampur. Okay, Palampur is in Himachal Pradesh. Palanpur is in Gujarat. Don't confuse the two. The answer is Gujarat. Gujarat is the milk state of India. Anand, which is a district in Gujarat, is the milk city of India. Even Amul is based in Anand. EU, European Union has recently signed a deal to normalize the relations with which country? In fact, US also made great attempts. In fact, United States also opened an embassy for the first time in 50 years in this country's capital, Havana. This country is Cuba. Recently, the revolutionary leader of Cuba, communist leader Fidel Castro, who ruled Cuba for almost 5 decades, he passed away. So the answer is Cuba. Cuba is also called sugar bowl of the world. Now, which bank has adopted Patunagar and Sachindranagar colony in the state of Tripura to convert them into cashless villages? Please note, you have to remember all the banks which are making these villages cashless. For example, Akodara. Now, you know that Akodara is the first digital village and the first cashless village in the country. It was made cashless by ICICI Bank. Similarly, there are 3 villages in Patna which are made cashless by Bank of Baroda. Whereas Patunagar and Sachindranagar, they will be made cashless by United Bank of India. United Bank of India was established before independence in 1943, headquartered at Kolkata. But please note that after independence, that is 1947, there is only one bank and one only, the headquarter of which is in any of the eastern states of India. It is Bandhan Bank, headquartered again at Kolkata. LIC Mutual Fund. Mutual Fund, the LIC asset management company, it is adopting the unified payment interface in partnership with which bank? Please note that there are 2 foreign banks which have adopted unified payment interface, which is a challenge in some ways to mobile wallet. Now, LIC Mutual Fund is adopting this in partnership with the foreign bank Standard Chartered Bank. Now, my second question for you today. One bank which has adopted unified payment interface is Standard Chartered. Which is the other? Only 2 foreign banks have adopted. One is Standard Chartered. Which is the other? Write down in comments if you know. Which country has reversed its demonetization decision after public outrage leading to anarchy? So in this country, their president, his name is Nicolas Maduro. Nicolas Maduro said that the rupee 100, not rupee, I mean the rupee of this country, which is called Bolivar. So 100 Bolivar note will be banned or it will be demonetized. But there was a outcry, there was a, there were protests just like in India. But this country succumbed to the demands and reversed its demonetization decision. So this country is Venezuela, oil rich country. Its economy heavily depends on oil. It is a member of OPEC also, and the capital is Caracas, Venezuela. And the name of the Venezuelan president is Nicolas Maduro. Which Indian has been listed in the Forbes magazine's second annual list of wealthiest entrepreneurs under the age of 40? There are 2 Indians, in fact, not one, in this list, in this esteemed list. One is Apurva Mehta and the second is Vivek Ramaswamy. So the answer is D, both B and C. Both of these gentlemen, they are below the age of 40 and they are listed in the wealthiest entrepreneurs, Indian entrepreneurs. Who has been elected as the president of Motorsports Clubs of India? That is FMSCI, Federation of Motorsports Clubs of India. And this decision was taken at their general meeting held in Chennai. The name of this person is Akbar Ibrahim. And he will take over from Zayan Khan, who is the outgoing president of the Federation of Motorsports Clubs of India. Who is the test captain of South African cricket team? So there are three formats, T20, ODI and test matches. In ODI, the captain is AB de Villiers, still there. T20, the captain is Faf du Plessis. And in test matches, which is the question, so in test matches, the captain was AB de Villiers, but he resigned. So the new captain is Faf du Plessis. Which Indian snooker player? So name is given, Pankaj Advani. He has won the IBSF World Billiards Championship. Now this is not the long up championship. This is the actual World Billiards Championship. So he has become the world champion. For which time? This is his which number World Billiards Championship. And he beat Peter Gilchrist, who is from Singapore, in the finals. So this is Pankaj Advani's 11th World Billiards Championship. And overall his 16th world title. But question will come like this. World Billiards Championship, he won it for which time? 11th time. And he beat Peter Gilchrist of Singapore in the final. Pankaj Advani is from Karnataka. Now, their first ever day and night Ashes Test match between England and Australia will be played at which ground in December 2017? So, you know that Ashes are, it is a traditional test match series between England and Australia. The first test match was played in 1877. The first ever test match was played between these two countries in 1877 at MCG, Melbourne Cricket Ground. And the first one-day match was also played between England and Australia. Much later, of course. But next year, in December, that is exactly 1 year from now. So 1 year hence, in December 2017, test match will be played between England and Australia. And it will be the first ever day and night Ashes test match. Where will it be played? It will be played at the Adelaide Oval in Australia. Government of Cuba has signed a deal to have faster internet connection with which technology giant? When it comes to internet, there is only one name that comes to mind, which is Google. Oh, I have not put Google in the options. So just replace one option with Google. Google is the answer. It will help Cuba to have faster internet. Which country abolished its practice of kafala? See, kafala is basically a practice where to do job in this country, you need a local person who is called your local sponsor. And if you want to change the job or if you want to leave the country, then you have to take his permission. So ultimately, your freedom is in his hands. And there were a lot of cases where, these local sponsors, they exploit the workers and all. So kafala system has been done away with. It was a very kind of a backward practice, anti-diluvian practice. It has been done away with in which country? This country is Qatar. The capital is Doha. And in fact, Bank of Doha opened its one of the branches in Kerala. That Bank of Doha was in news. And Qatar will host the Football World Cup in 2022. In 2018, the World Cup will be in Russia. What will be our GDP growth according to the Asian Development Bank? Asian Development Bank, the president is Takehiko Nakao. See, it is a Japan-dominated bank. Asian Development Bank has headquarter is in Manila, which is the capital of Philippines. Now, each and every bank or organization or credit rating agency, they are lowering India's GDP forecast because of demonetization. Previously, Asian Development Bank was saying that we will grow at 7.4% in 2016, but after demonetization, it is 7%. Now, 7.6% is by United Nations for our GDP forecast for 2016. And 7.9% was as per CRISIL, but CRISIL reduced it from 7.9% to 6.9%. CRISIL. Which country has signed a grant agreement of $5.19 million with IBRD? What is IBRD? International Bank for Reconstruction and Development. And this is basically to finance energy efficiency projects, MSME projects, that is micro, small and medium enterprises projects for energy security, energy efficiency and so on. And for that, there is a grant of $5.19 million. So this agreement has been signed between IBRD and India. Now, India is the largest recipient of funds, loans from World Bank in its entire history. which company launched M-Pesa Pay for cashless transactions, for replacing sales, that is the act like micro ATMs, point of sales machines. So M-Pesa Pay is launched by Vodafone. Lot of apps these days, there's Paytm, there's MobiQuick, there's Citrus, Oxygen and so on. So please keep a check of who is partnering with whom. There are a lot of questions. This is an important question. Which airport in India has achieved carbon neutral status? And it has become only the second airport in India to do so, and the first in this category, which is the 5 to 15 million passengers per annum category. So 5 to 15 million passengers per annum category, this airport is Rajiv Gandhi International Airport in Hyderabad. Now please note that the first airport in India to achieve carbon neutral status was Indira Gandhi International Airport at New Delhi. But this airport is not in this category, that is 5 to 15 million. It is in much higher category, because a lot of it is much bigger and better and busier airport than Rajiv Gandhi International Airport in Hyderabad. So the question is, which airport achieved carbon neutral status? It is Rajiv Gandhi International Airport. It has become the second airport overall in Asia Pacific, not just in India, but the first in this category. So please mark accordingly. Veer Savarkar International Airport is in Port Blair, Andaman, and Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose Airport is in Kolkata. Who took over the post of the chief executive of the Indian Bank Association? Indian Bank Association, who is the new chief executive? The name is V.G. Kannan. V.G. Kannan has taken over as the new, and whom will he replace? He will replace M.V. Tanksail. M.V. Tanksail. Now, this is a sport, okay? That is why I put photo here. You, I'm sure, would not have heard of this sport. This is called bobsleigh and skeleton. Bobsleigh and skeleton world championships were supposed to take place in this country. But as always, the athletes or the players of this country, they were charged of doping. That is taking banned steroids and all, you know, anabolic steroids and erythropoietin and all these substances. So this country was banned from hosting the 2017 bobsleigh and skeleton world championship. Which country is this? Even during Olympic Games, this country was accused of wrongdoings. This is Russia. Who won the gold medal in the national boxing championship? That is, who is the new national boxing champion in the 60 kg, that is the lightweight category? In boxing, there are a lot of categories like lightweight, welterweight, heavyweight, and also all. In 60 category, which is the lightweight category, it is our veteran Shiv Thapa. Shiv Thapa is the new national boxing champion in 60 kg category, and this national boxing championship took place in Guwahati. That question can also come. Where did the national boxing championship took place? Guwahati in Assam. Same question, different weight category. Who won the gold medal in the 69 kg category in the same national boxing championship? It is the boxer Manoj Kumar. Sometime for boxer, you will also see the word pugilist. Next question, and this is a very important question, because in this question, there are 5 questions. The question is, the International Tennis Federation has named which player as the 2016 ITF World Champions? So, ITF World Champions are, this title is given to players who have performed exceptional in that year and who performed exceptionally well. In fact, all the three. But this was given to Andy Murray and Angelique Kerber. So, the answer is both B and C. And I'll tell you why. See, Monica Puig, she is from Puerto Rico. Okay, small country. Puerto Rico, and she won the Olympic gold medal in the women's single category. Andy Murray is from Scotland, and he won the, you know, Olympic gold medal, he won Wimbledon, he won lots of tournaments. Angelique Kerber, she was the firm favorite for Olympic gold medal, but she did not win because Monica Puig beat her in the final. So Angelique Kerber won Olympic silver medal, but she was able to win Australian Open and US Open. So that is why Andy Murray and Angelique Kerber had a far better year than the rest. So the answer is both B and C. Monica Puig is from Puerto Rico, Angelique Kerber is from Germany, Andy Murray is from Scotland, Britain. Britain means Scotland, Wales and England combined. That is called Britain or Great Britain. Scotland capital is Edinburgh, Wales capital is Cardiff, and England capital is London. Walton Swinburne, he passed away recently. He was related to which sport? Walton Swinburne, he passed away. So he was related to horse riding because he was a jockey. Jockey means a person who rides horse. When do we observe the World Energy Conservation Day across the world? So basically, energy security is one of the prime concerns of each country, and also the focus should be on clean energy, because now, of course, most of the countries are signatory to the COP21 Paris Conference. So they are legally binding now to have clean energy, to have low carbon emission and all that, to have low carbon footprint. So we need to spread awareness about all the renewable forms of energy. World Energy Conservation Day takes into account all of these issues. And World Energy Conservation Day, therefore, we celebrate every year on December the 14th. Rajya Sabha recently passed the Rights of Persons with Disabilities Bill. Very, very important bill. Because it has increased the number of people who are considered disabled. You know, the new categories are added. So, in the old bill was of the year 1995 and it was called Protection of Rights and Full Participation Act of 1995. Now the new bill, it has amended this 1995 bill. Okay. So in this bill, how many disabilities are covered in the new bill? See, in the old bill, 7 disabilities were covered. But in the new bill, 19 disabilities are covered. So the increase in disabilities is by 12. There was a ban which was imposed by our National Green Tribunal on which object that poses a danger to humans, birds, and also it causes harm to environment because it is non-biodegradable. Which object among these four has been banned by the National Green Tribunal? It is called manja. For those who don't know, when we fly kite, the thread that we use, it is called manja in Hindi or in some other language. I'm not sure. It might be an Urdu word. So the glass powder coated manja, it is very ominous for birds, because birds, they sometimes have injuries because of this. Their body gets cut into two pieces sometimes. And also humans also. Sometimes what happens is, this manja, it touches a electric wire and there is a current, or there have been numerous instances. In fact, it can pierce human skin also. And it is harmful to environment because, it is non-biodegradable. Now, which book was released by the apex court of the country, that is the Supreme Court? And this book is about, this book has a comprehensive history of courts and judicial system in India. This was a book which was released by the Supreme Court of India, the apex court. So this book is called Courts of India Past to Present. That is D, Courts of India Past to Present. Which city officially entered into the United Nations list of World Heritage Sites? And already UNESCO has given the title of World Heritage Site to this city, but now United Nations has given this. So which city is this? This city in the year 2016 organized Olympic Games, and in the year 2014 it organized the Football FIFA World Cup. This is Rio de Janeiro, the city of the Christ the Redeemer. It's Rio de Janeiro in Brazil. Fortaleza is also a city in Brazil. Rome is in Italy. Paris is in France. Indian government has signed a memorandum of understanding with which country for strengthening cooperation in the field of tourism? So basically these two countries will, help each other grow business, help each other grow number of tourists, etc. Indian government has signed a memorandum with which country? This country is called Kyrgyzstan. The capital of Kyrgyzstan is Bishkek. The capital of Uzbekistan is Tashkent. Very, very cold countries. Afghanistan, the capital is Kabul. Belarus, the capital is Minsk. And there is one more country, very confusing, Kazakhstan. The capital of Kazakhstan is Astana. So please revise these again and again and again. Our cabinet has given its approval for signing of a revised air services agreement between India and which country? See, air services agreement is regarding, how many flights will go to this country and all that, how much area those flights can cover, whether they can go into a particular city or they can go to any city of this country and all that. Our last air services agreement with this country was in the year 1978. It was signed on 31st January 1978. So, past 38 years, the old air service agreement was monitored, was implemented. But now, there is a new air services agreement with this country. This country is Nigeria. African country Nigeria, the capital is Lagos. Ghana, the capital is Accra. Zaire, Kinshasa, and Egypt is Cairo. With which country ISRO, ISRO is what? Indian Space Research Organization. So with which country ISRO has signed a memorandum of understanding for cooperation in the exchange and use of land remote sensing satellite data? This is very, very important. Both the countries, if they share the remote sensing data, it will be very useful. And this we have signed with USA. The space agency of USA is called NASA, It is headquartered in Washington, D.C., the capital of the United States. ISRO headquarters is in Bengaluru. That is why Bengaluru is also called the space city. Russia's space agency is also very, very powerful. It is called Roscosmos. China is also good. Japan is called JAXA. So Japan Aeronautical Exploration Agency, JAXA. So you should know some of these things. Now, India has been ranked at which position as the most vacation deprived country in the world? Most vacation deprived. So ask me, what is the meaning of vacation deprivation? Anyways, so India works a lot. That is proved by this, because we are fourth most vacation deprived, means we don't get vacations. Which is number one country in this? It is Spain and UAE. They are shared number one. And in this, you should know number two and three also, because we are number four. Second in this list is Malaysia. The capital is Kuala Lumpur. And third is South Korea. South Korea, the capital is Seoul. And we are fourth. Which country will host the 5th Indian Arab Partnership Conference for mutual enhancement in the economic ties? India wants to enhance its economic ties with the Arab countries. For that, there will be a 5th Indian Arab Partnership Conference in Muscat, the capital of Oman. Who has taken over as the acting president of South Korea? Because Park Geun-hye, who the lady who was their ex-president, she was impeached by the parliament because of corruption. In fact, corruption of the order of $30 billion. Some were saying that, some newspapers were claiming that she has done, or she has been charged with commission and omission. Anyways, so Park Geun-hye, she has been impeached by the parliament. Who has taken over as the acting president till the next general elections? So it is Mr. Hwang Kyo-han. Hwang Kyo-han. And don't confuse South Korea with North Korea. North Korea is very isolated kingdom. That is why it is called the Hermit Kingdom. The capital of North Korea is Pyongyang. And dictator is Kim Jong-un. South Korea is a proper democracy. The capital is Seoul. And South Korea has very good companies also. Like Hyundai car company, like Samsung, LG. You know, all these are South Korean companies. Now, which city hosted the first ever India-China Think Tank Forum? Think Tank Forum, first ever between India and China. It was recently hosted by New Delhi. And China was basically not happy with India. Why? China said to India that the president of India, Pranab Mukherjee, should not host Dalai Lama. But he still, he still did it. So China was unhappy, and that is why China has denied Hong Kong visa on arrival to India now. So the things between India and China are not looking good. Vanjeevan is basically a program to identify the problems of livelihood issues. So basically there are problems with skill development and, problems in livelihood. It has been launched in how many states? By United Nations Development Program, UNDP. And in fact, UNDP has launched it in association with our tribal commissions. So that is our Union Ministry of Tribal Affairs. Has collaborated with UNDP for the same. Vanjeevan has been launched in 6 states. So the answer is 6. And these 6 states are Assam, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Odisha and Telangana. Now there was a fourth biannual photo exhibition of all the news cameramen. As you know, they have formed something known as All India Working News Cameramen's Association. So where was it inaugurated recently? Fourth biannual photo exhibition. It was recently inaugurated in New Delhi. The answers to most of these questions is in fact New Delhi. Who is the CEO of Prasar Bharati, who was in news recently? And why was he this gentleman in news? Because, he had inaugurated something known as a Prasar Bharati Archives Sales Counter at Akashvani Bhavan in New Delhi. So he was in news. So Prasar Bharati CEO is S.C. Panda. Now the government has decided to write off or waive the service tax on debit and credit card transactions up to how much amount to promote digital transaction. So you will not have to pay service tax up to a transaction of this much amount if you are paying it by cashless. This amount is 2000 rupees. In fact, one more thing. RBI has done away with the double authentication for payments up to 2000. It is voluntary. You can avail this service. You don't have to enter OTP and your this 4-digit PIN if you avail this service. So that is also for 2000 rupees. And the mobile wallet limit has been increased from 10,000 to 20,000. Which mobile application has been launched by Indian Army that facilitates the route guidance on a Google map. So it's basically for easy route guidance, Pathfinder kind of an app by Indian Army. What is the name? The name is Veterans Outreach. This is very, very important. Veterans Outreach. Where has been the India-UK conference on the ease of doing business recently held to enhance the strategic bilateral partnership between the two countries? So India and the United Kingdom. Now, what is the difference between United Kingdom and Britain? See, Britain is your Scotland, Wales and England. Okay. And United Kingdom has also has North Ireland. That is the only difference. So don't get too technical. You can use it interchangeably sometimes, but not in the exams. So India-UK conference on ease of doing business was recently held again in New Delhi. Where did the 5th Indian Arab Partnership Conference take place? This I told you, it is in Muscat in Oman. Now, this is an important question. So, which Indian hockey player, he is the captain of the Indian hockey team. I am talking about senior hockey team. But for the junior, that is the under 21 hockey team, he is the goalkeeping coach also. And he is the goalkeeper of Indian senior team also. What is his name? His name is P.R. Srijesh. Who has been appointed for the important position as United States government's ambassador to China? Who Trump has elected as their ambassador to China? And this will be very crucial because the relations between United States and China are at an all-time low. In fact, China recently, they snatched their submarine from the South China Sea. The problem is South China Sea is almost 10,000 miles from United States. That is why United States has not been able to gain adequate control. United States cannot control South China Sea without the help of Japan and India. That is why Japan, India and United States, they do Malabar exercise in the Indian Ocean. So this person is Terry Branstad. He has been appointed as United States ambassador to China. Which bank in the private sector has got the best MSME bank award? That is Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises award by SOCHAM. This bank is Karnataka Bank. Karnataka Bank. The headquarter is in Mangaluru. Which player has been named as the highest paid athlete of all time by Forbes? And his earnings, $1.7 billion. This is the earnings of a sportsman. So this he was a basketball legend, almost synonymous name with basketball, Michael Jordan. Cristiano Ronaldo, he recently won his 4th Ballon d'Or. That is the best player in the world for 4th time. Lionel Messi has won Ballon d'Or 5th time. Cristiano Ronaldo plays for Portugal. He is the captain of Portugal team and he plays for Real Madrid Football Club in Spain. Lionel Messi plays for Barcelona Football Club in the Catalonia region of Spain and for Argentina national team. Tiger Woods plays golf. When do we observe the United Nations International Anti-Corruption Day? Also, Sonia Gandhi's birthday falls on this day. International Anti-Corruption Day. So, when do we observe this day? And this is basically to, you know, stop corruption, spread awareness about the same. It is observed every year on December the 9th. John Glenn, legendary John Glenn, he was an astronaut, he was a politician, you know, he was a senator. He died recently. He belonged to which country? So he was from United States of America. What is the name of the website that is launched by our Railway Minister Suresh Prabhu for the National Rail Plan 2030? So Suresh Prabhu has given a National Rail Plan for 2030 and for that there has been a website opened. A launch that is called www.nationalrailplan.in. Simple. So the answer is B. Which city hosted the 28th SIMCON? SIMCON means State Information Ministers Conference recently. State Information Ministers Conference, again, it took place in New Delhi. Which country's Secretary of Defense, Mr. Ashton Carter, finalized India's status as a major defense partner? So India is now a very strategic major defense partner of this country. This country is the United States of America and the Secretary of Defense is Ashton Carter. Which bank appointed Veena Mankar as its non-executive chairperson? This bank is the IDFC Bank and she has replaced Mr. Anil Bajial. Mr. Anil Bajial as the executive, non-executive chairman. Now there was a 7-day Serendipity Arts Festival. It recently is going on in which it is ending tomorrow, in fact, in Goa. What does the word serendipity means? Vocab. Serendipity means an accidental discovery, like the discovery of the structure of, you know, benzene or discovery of radium. You know, all of these were serendipity. which High Court in India has said that the triple talaq or talaq, that is talaq-e-bidat practice is unconstitutional and violates the rights of the woman which are enshrined in the Constitution. Now, there is a video on triple talaq which has been made by our legal specialist Mr. Ayush Sanghi. Do check that video out. It has covered this video exquisitely. This is the Allahabad High Court which has said so. What was the theme for our Human Rights Day 2016? So there have been numerous, you know, human rights violations across the globe, and we spread awareness about the same. We try to give the dignity to every individual and so on and so forth. So Human Rights Day, we observe it every year on December the 10th. But what was the theme this year? The theme this year was stand up for someone's rights today. Stand up for someone's rights today. Which committee on digital payments recommended a medium-term strategy if India is to grow its digital payments, cashless transactions in India? It needs to have a medium-term strategy. These were the recommendations of this committee on digital payment. What was the name of this committee? The name of this committee is Ratan Vattal Committee. Another question. Our IT minister, the Information and Technology Minister, Ravi Shankar Prasad, recently launched a project to enable every citizen, small traders and merchants to adopt digital payment again. What was the name that was given to this project? Again, based on digital, the name of this project is Digi Dhan Abhiyan. So don't get confused between Digi Shala, which is a TV channel, and Digi Dhan. Which state chief minister launched a mobile app called Whistle Now? So who is a whistleblower? Whistleblower is a person who, if he sees wrongdoing anywhere, he tells everyone that he's called a whistleblower. So Whistle Now is an app which is aimed at fighting corruption. In fact, he launched two apps. One was called Arising Kerala and second is Whistle Now. So it was launched by Mr. Pinarayi Vijayan of the Kerala state. Which country topped the list of countries most affected by terrorism in 2015 according to Global Terrorism Index 2016, which was released by the Institute for Economics and Peace? Which is the country which is worst affected by terrorism? It is Iraq. And India is at which position? India is at 7th position. India is 7th most impacted country by terrorism. Which country has launched a cargo service which connects Tibet with Nepal? The capital of Nepal is Kathmandu. Nepal's Prime Minister is Mr. Prachand, and Tibet capital is Lhasa. It is under Chinese occupation. So there is a cargo service started between Tibet and Nepal by China. India and which country, they have signed a civil nuclear cooperation agreement which is aimed at mutual defense cooperation? This is a positive step because this country is anti-China. We are anti-China, so we need to have good relations with all the countries which are anti-China. So this country is Vietnam, the capital is Hanoi, and there will be mutual cooperation in nuclear technology. Who won the Ghana's national election, becoming the new president of Ghana? Ghana capital is Accra, and this country has democracy and very important African country, very active in football also. So Ghana's new president is Mr. Nana Akufo-Addo. Now there is a documentary. The director of this documentary is Onir, the famous documentarian. So this documentary is about Down syndrome, which is an important syndrome, trisomy in children, causes mental retardness, a lot of things. I'll not go into much details. So Down syndrome, and it won the best foreign documentary award. It got the award of recognition at the Australian Film Festival. What was the name of the documentary directed by Onir? The name was Raising the Bar. La La Land is a movie, Ryan Gosling. Do check that out. It's a musical, romantic musical, Emma Stone and Ryan Gosling. Who has launched this project? It is a campaign, 100 million for 100 million. And it is launched by Kailash Satyarthi's foundation, who has done seminal work in stopping, you know, child trafficking. He is also a Nobel laureate. If you remember, Kailash Satyarthi and Malala Yousafzai, they had won the Nobel Prize that year. So 100 million for 100 million is basically 100 million children who have not got their basic human rights or they have suffered. They will become like a source of inspiration for another 100 million kids. And this project was inaugurated by our President Pranab Mukherjee. Ajit Mohan Committee has been constituted by Internet and Mobile Association of India for what purpose? Ajit Mohan Committee is for checking online piracy. online piracy, like online your torrents and your online CD piracy, DVD piracy and all that. Who inaugurated the 5 months long Narmada Seva Yatra? This is basically to reduce the pollution in the Narmada River. So Narmada River takes its origin from Amarkantak, which is called the pilgrimage of pilgrimages. Very, very important. Amarkantak, and this project, this Narmada Seva Yatra was in fact launched at Amarkantak only by Shivraj Singh Chauhan, the Chief Minister of Madhya Pradesh of the Bharatiya Janata Party. Narmada River is very, very important. It is a western flowing river, Narmada and Tapi both. And it forms estuaries, not delta, because it flows in rift valleys. And Narmada River takes its origin from Amarkantak, then it goes to Maharashtra. It touches some towns of Maharashtra and then it goes to its destination Gujarat in Bharuch. And Tapi is another river which is called the twin sister, twin of Narmada, and it is also a western flowing river. So these are some important facts. Do read about rivers of India. Which bank announced that it will launch a credit card for the, you know, lower socioeconomic strata, that is the people at the bottom of the pyramid, low net worth individuals, so to say, and the cap will be ₹25,000. This will be the limit, credit limit for this card. Who will launch this card for promoting cashless transaction? It is the largest lender in India, Chair Manager Undhati Bhattacharya. It is State Bank of India, which is getting launched with six banks, but very recently approval was given to Bharatiya Mahila Bank Limited. When do we observe the International Mountain Day? And this is basically to spread awareness about the importance of mountains in our daily lives, and you know, mountains which are one of the cradles of our civilization, they give rise to rivers and all that. So this is International Mountain Day is observed every year on December the 11th. Who was appointed as the new Prime Minister of New Zealand? So the Prime Minister of New Zealand was John Key, but he resigned. He said that he wants to spend time with his family and he wants to promote new talent. He does not want to stand in the way of the new talents. So the new conservative leader, now the Prime Minister of New Zealand, is Bill English. New Zealand capital is Wellington. It lies to the east of Australia. Who has been elected as the president of the 90th Akhil Bharatiya Marathi Sahitya Sammelan? 90th Akhil Bharatiya Marathi Sahitya Sammelan. This will take place from 3rd to 5th of February 2017. It will be the 90th Sammelan and its president is Akshay Kumar M. Kale, who is a Marathi poet. Antonio Guterres, he took oath. He was sworn in as the new Secretary General of the United Nations, replacing Ban Ki-moon. So Antonio Guterres was the ex-prime minister. He is the ex-prime minister of which country? He is the ex-prime minister of Portugal. This is as easy a question as you can get. Portugal capital is Lisbon. Following the resignation of Matteo Renzi, so you know that Matteo Renzi was the Prime Minister of Italy. He resigned because he wanted to amend the constitution, but the voting in against him was 60, no, 40, yes. So he had to resign. And who has replaced him as the Prime Minister of Italy? Italy, the capital is Rome. The person who has replaced him is Paolo Gentiloni. Now, there is a carrier called Long March. It is the carrier of which country? It was in news recently because of the launches of weather satellites in geostationary orbit from the Xichang Satellite Launch Center in southwest China. So it is a carrier of China. And India's carrier is like PSLV and all these are Indian carriers. Who became the first Indian captain to score three double centuries in test match cricket? First Indian captain to score three double centuries in test match cricket is none other than Virat Kohli. Karun Nair, he scored a 300, I think, against England. We won the 5-match series against England 4-0. Now, the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, who is from the Telugu Desam Party, he has launched a website which is called abedb.gov.in, where what does E stands for? So basically, this is the state's Andhra Pradesh Dash Development Board. So it is E stands for economic. Which country has launched a cargo ship that is called Kaunotori, and this ship will basically go to the International Space Station in HIIB rocket. So remember the name of the carrier also, it is HIIB, and the name of the cargo ship is Kaunotori. It is launched by JAXA, which is Japanese space agency, JAXA. What is a toll-free number that will be started across the country so that awareness about cashless mode of transaction can be imparted? And basically, if you have any doubt about cashless transaction, digital payment, just call this number. This number is 14444. It was informed by, this new number was informed by NASSCOM President Mr. R. Chandrasekhar. Which train was recently renamed as Vizag Steel Samta Express? to promote Vizag Steel? So the name of this train was Samta Express. So the answer is C, very easy question. And they have put deliberately Vizag Steel in front of it so that it is called Vizag Steel Samta Express. It is a train from New Delhi to Thiruvananthapuram and from Hazrat Nizamuddin Railway Station to Trivandrum. NABARD, which was established in 1982. It's a bank for agriculture and agriculture bank for rural development. It has granted rupees 228 crore for, deployment of point of sales machines, which work as micro ATM. And this is basically, these ATMs will provide debit facility to farmers. EMV waste debit card for farmer. Who is the chairman of NABARD, who was in news because of this grant? It is Mr. Harsh Kumar Bhanwala. Now our president Pranab Mukherjee, he presented the Shilp Guru Award and national awards to master craftsperson for the year 2015 at Rashtrapati Bhavan. What was the number of the recipients? What was the number of the recipients, both the Shilp Gurus and the national awardees? So it was 19 national awardees and 9 Shilp Gurus. So the answer is A. Which acclaimed sculptor? Now one sculptor I told you, Helen Martin, who recently passed away. Now which acclaimed sculptor has been appointed as the new director of the National Gallery of Modern Art? Again an important question. And he will replace Mr. Rajiv Lochan, who is the outgoing. So it is Odisha-based sculptor Advitya Gadanayak. And there is one person who makes these sand statues on Puri beaches. I think his name is Sudarshan Patnaik. He is also from Odisha. He keeps winning a lot of these competitions also. Do remember his name also. Sudarshan Patnaik. Who became the first Indian to win a medal at Mr. Olympia event? Mr. Olympia, it is a bodybuilding event which took place in Hong Kong. So who became the first Indian to win a medal? He won the silver medal in this event. He is from Mumbai. His name is Iqbal Saeed. Which state government has launched country's first amphibious bus project? Amphibious takes its, the word comes from amphibian, which are the animals which can survive in both land and the water, like frog, Rana Tigrin and all that. So amphibious bus can run in water also, it can run on land also. Yes, and this project was launched at Harike Wetland. In fact, the name of the amphibious bus project has also been named after Harike Wetland. This service was launched in Punjab, which has a Shiromani Akali Dal and BJP joint government, and Chief Minister is Prakash Singh Badal. Who is the new Director General of Inter Services Intelligence, ISI? So ISI, who is the new Chief of ISI? So all these four options are important. Rahil Sharif was the Army Chief. He is now retired. So his position has been taken by General Kamar Bajwa, who is the new Pakistan Chief of Army Staff. Then Lieutenant General Naved Mukhtar, yes, he is the new ISI Chief and he has taken over from Lieutenant General Rizwan Akhtar. So Lieutenant General Rizwan Akhtar is the outgoing ISI Chief and Lieutenant General Naveen Mukhtar is the incumbent. Who was named as UNICEF Goodwill Ambassador? Who was named as UNICEF's Goodwill Ambassador? UNICEF headquarter is in New York, the same place where the headquarter of United Nations is also there, and it is Priyanka Chopra. Priyanka Chopra, and the name of the campaign is For Every Child. For Every Child is the name of the campaign launched by UNICEF. Which football player won the Ballon d'Or? So I told you already, Ballon d'Or is given to the best player of the year, best football player in the world for the year. It is given to Cristiano Ronaldo of Real Madrid and Portugal team. Where was the 6th edition of Asia Pacific Ministerial Conference on Housing and Urban Development take place? Asia Pacific's Ministerial Conference on Housing and Urban Development again took place in New Delhi. It was the 6th edition. India will contribute how much amount to the United Nations Central Emergency Response Fund, also called CERF, for the year 2016-2017. This is like a grant, like a donation. It is 5 lakh US dollars. Grofers. Grofers has partnered with which bank for its new scheme for its consumers to get cash delivered at home up to rupees 2000? So Grofers is basically, it is an on-demand e-commerce mobile and web application, mobile app Grofers. Do download this app. It has partnered with Yes Bank. Which digital payment company has partnered with NHAI? The headquarter of NHAI is in New Delhi, and NHAI is responsible for building all the state and national highways. But if you talk about the highways on, borders and mountains, it is built by Border Road Organization. But the headquarter of Border Road Organization is also in New Delhi. Now, NHAI, you can just pay your toll with the, digitally now. And the the partnership has been done with Paytm. You can scan your QR code and do the transaction. Sultan Muhammad V, he is sworn in as the king of which country? So he is sworn in as the king of Malaysia. He will be their 15th king. Malaysia's capital is Kuala Lumpur. And there was a tragedy. The football players of Chapecoense football club, it is a Brazilian football club, they met with an air crash and all of them died. Who was the Chapecoense goalkeeper who was killed? And he was named as the Brazilian player of the year in an online voting. His name is Danilo. Do remember the name of this football club. It is very important for your exam. Chapecoense. Who won the most improved player award at the Badminton World Federation annual function held in Dubai? She is on song. She won the Olympic silver medal, PV Sindhu. And she recently beat in the Super Series Carolina Marin, whom she had lost to in the Olympics. Who has been named as one of the 15 global thinkers? Because she has given lot of importance to Twitter diplomacy, and it was given by the Foreign Policy, also called FP magazine, which is a US-based magazine. She recently got a kidney transplant also. Sushma Swaraj, External Affairs Minister. What is the rank of India in the world's top military budget spenders? In fact, India has overtaken Russia also and Saudi Arabia also. India spends more than $50 billion. For a developing country like India to spend $50 billion annually on military can be very unbecoming in some people's view. Anyways, what is the rank of India? It is 4th. Number one spender is US, then China, then UK, then India, then Saudi Arabia, and then Russia. In which city will India's largest indoor sports arena will be built, which will have a capacity of 15,400 people at one time? It will be built in Kolkata, largest indoor stadium. Which IAS officer and mountaineer recently wrote this book, Mani Everest, an inspiring story of transforming dream into reality? Everest, you know, also called Sagarmath in Nepal, is the highest mountain in the world with a mountain peak 8848 meter. And this was written by Ravinder Kumar, IAS. Whew, so long video, and the quality of questions was absolutely brilliant this time. I took 2 days. In fact, it took me to make all the current affairs, to check all the news so that no single current affair is missed. So do like, comment, subscribe, share, do whatever you like. Thank you. Bye.